It's the dog's intro this time.
Okay, so weekly check in six.
Six, yeah.
Is that all it's been, huh?
Featuring neighbor dog.
Yeah, featuring this guy, the neighbor dog that you know and love so well. Andy, Evan Walker, normal stuff, and Walker bought a moped.
Yeah, today I went down to District 1, which is, I went to the Backpacker Street, the big spot, and there was a guy who I remember like running into the first day I was here. I was walking around that street and I was looking at buying a moped because these guys were out way out by the airport, and so I was like, well, I'll just do it. I was ready
first day,
but I didn't do it. And like building up that not doing it and riding in Ubers, riding on the back of like the Uber for taxis called Grab here, I got a fear in me. I was super nervous today, and like buying it, I was like,
yeah.
I was like I was with Maya. I went with this Vietnamese girl, and she was like, you should test drive it. And I was kind of like, you do you want to test drive it? Like, we're on this not even busy street.
Yeah.
But I was just like super nervous. But now I'm good. I've been driving all day. Got a little suntan.
Oh yeah, you
tan
did.
From it.
A little moped tan.
Yeah, it's been so nice. It's been so fun.
I'm excited to mess around with it in these little alleys.
Yeah. Yeah, it'll be cool. Maybe I'll let you.
Yeah, maybe you won't.
So it cost me $1 million dong, which is $44 for a month. I put a deposit of $4 million dong down, which is $175. And that guy I will never see again. He has my money and he's gone. Psych.
And it's gone.
Just kidding. It's a reputable shed.
A
garage door that I know and love.
It's also worth saying we're drinking what could be equated to Michelob Ultra. We didn't really know it when we purchased it, but it's very light.
Yeah, it's... what's the word? It sucks pretty bad.
It's a ketogenic beer? Is it ketogenic?
No beer is.
Okay, well, Michelob Ultra is close.
Anyways, moving on.
Well, our next story, it would have been Saturday. Walker and I were wanting to go to a rock climbing place that is in District 2. Two?
Yep.
Two.
Which I.
It's worth saying that District 2 is super...
Whoa. Dude. Downwind from that, too.
Sorry, man. District 2 is super wealthy. We were going past huge houses down there. Very different than mostly the city that we've spent time in. But anyway, we get to this rock climbing place, and it ended up not even being open. They were having a Songkran.
Yeah,
is how you pronounce that?
Songkran, I think so. It's a Thai festival, like the New Year.
Yep, the New Year.
Where
were they water blasting too?
Basically, they just water blast each other. They all have super soakers and balloons and like fire hoses, and everybody's just fighting with the water
great
in the street.
Fun.
Yeah,
I wish I would have known that was going on.
So happened last. That's where Alex went.
He went to Thailand.
Yeah. So the whole
we'll link a video in the bio. The guy that got us out here, he went over to Songkran in Thailand this past week, and so that'll be a cool video for you to check out.
And what that is the whole country every New Year it's just a big countrywide water fight, and it's supposed to be like washing away the last year, so you're like fresh for the New Year, and it's like a 3-day festival. Yeah, there's plenty of videos you can look into it. It's pretty cool. And so the place where the rock climbing was, they were having their own little one. There was even like a truck with like a big water tank, you know, like a fuel truck, but it was like full of water that they had pulled up to that.
A big water bottle, you could call
a
it.
Big
on
water
wheels,
bottle.
A mobile water bottle.
Yeah.
Analogene. But so the rock wall was closed that day, and so we didn't get to go rock climbing, but we did go across the street and had lunch at this little Vietnamese restaurant, like the typical local, like, small tables with small chairs just kind of set out.
Like a reputable shed?
Yeah, a shed. And sheds are the best, man. And we're sitting there, and this guy sits next to us, and we start talking to him. He speaks really good English, and we asked him, he's 53, speaks very good English. And he learned it for free by just listening to BBC and stuff like that.
Does he talk with that accent?
No, which is interesting. But, he works for Philip Morris. He's a driver, drives people around. And we talked to him for a while. He was just super happy, super chill. Evan talked to him about, like, what it was like being in Saigon.
To paint the picture of it in this, like, little, you know, restaurant, little shed area is, I mean, there's, like, a couple locals are playing, like, they're gambling in the corner. We don't really know what they're doing. And we're at this table
playing Hungry Hippos.
Yeah, pretty much. And
there were some giant roosters walking around.
Yeah.
Like thick.
Some fatties.
Thick.
For sure.
Roosters.
And anyway, we're just sitting at this table with like these weird sort of like lawn chair things. I don't know, just mismatching furniture. And the we're very close to the river. And there's this little like inlet of the river where there's some fishermen who have these really long poles trying to catch catfish. It was just super relaxed, super nice breeze. And, you know, he just sat down to us, sat down with us, and kind of we started talking to him. And, yeah, he was, I think, 12 or 13 years old when the North Vietnamese took over Saigon and or liberated Saigon, right? And we asked him, like, you know, how did you feel? And actually his mother and father were in the South Vietnamese army, so they were very afraid for their lives. And he also talked about how at the time, you know, it's kind of famous for the mass exodus that was happening in Saigon. And he talked about how there was boats on the river with just older men, younger males, like loading these boats because like these are the people who are actually part of the army. So they're actually very afraid of just getting murdered when the war's over. So it was just a mass exodus. And he just defined the amount of fear that they were feeling. And actually his parents left, his parents survived. And they left Vietnam, I want to say like 6 years later, and they emigrated to the U.S.
Yeah.
And so him and his siblings were still here. They stayed. But he's visited the U.S. and everything. But yeah, I mean, I think what was one of the coolest things for me meeting him was, first of all, a 53-year-old that speaks English is pretty rare. I mean, if they're in a profession like he is, he's a driver. You know, he's not like he's a reputable businessman or anything like that. So that stuck out.
And he spoke
damn cigarette smuggler, not reputable.
Well,
no, he's a driver for this.
Like he,
I know.
Yeah.
Anyways, yeah, his English was great, and that was cool.
But what I was gonna say was that he came up to us. And you know, sometimes we, like, as white people, we're sort of like spectacles, you know, and people just kind of like want to be around us so they can get a picture with us. And that's not what he sat with us at all. He sat down, had a conversation with us. We enjoyed our conversations, and he was like, "Hey guys, I'm gonna go do this gambling thing. Like, nice meeting you guys. Talk to you later." Like,
yeah.
It was just like really weird.
And that's something that I've found more in like China. They just look at you like a spectacle. And I mean, China was closed off till 79. Saigon has had, like, I mean, the French were here for forever, so they're used to it. But, like, China, you definitely get looked at like more of a spectacle. They're, wow, and they'll just take pictures of you, like, walking down. And here it's less. And in Thailand, our buddy Charles is telling us, in Thailand, it's like, yeah, they're super friendly, but they want your money out of it. This guy didn't want anything from us but to just sit there and shoot the shit while he ate, and you know, it's
funny.
It was
cool.
He showed us some videos on his phone of like catfish and stuff like that.
Yeah.
Fishing and,
huh.
Yeah. So speaking of being freaks and people taking pictures of us,
while they were doing that, I was getting my hair cut down the way here, and they were, you know, I was getting my hair cut and I got a fresh cut, as you can see, and you know, it's like you go to some place in the States and it's like, I feel like the guy who cut my hair is the guy who owned this farm shop. Like, this guy was like, this is professional.
Yeah.
This is thing, you know. And so, like, I got a good haircut. But, like, during it, like, this lady's, like, taking photos of me. It was just, it was really weird. Because, and you could tell, like, they took pictures with me. And, like, it's because I've been, like, a fucking redhead freak out here. It's like, what is this thing? Like, let's cut that. That'll be so funny and hilarious. but no, I got a really good haircut, and the people were super nice, and I also got, like, a really long massage in the middle of it, like, a head massage, you know, where they, like, shampoo your stuff.
Yeah.
But they, like, I mean, the massage was really long. This lady was also, like, doing all these weird, like, she was, like, it was some weird slapping. It was weird, but I was into it.
She was
and,
trying to scrub the freckles off.
Yeah, she didn't know.
So
but, yeah, I got my haircut,
face,
and I
dirt.
Paid $5 for a haircut and a little massage, and that was that. It was a good
$5.
Yeah, $5.
You paid $100K for that?
Yeah.
Damn, I got mine cut for $35K the other day.
Yeah, that's why you're wearing a hat, buddy.
Oh,
I'm wearing a hat because I got helmet head because I've been ripping that new head all over.
But yeah, sometimes you do feel it's like a little bit of a show pony, but it's, I mean, who cares really?
And he likes the attention because normally people just, you know, ignore him. So he loves any sort of attention.
Subscribe.
Anything I can get, subscribe, please.
I guess it'll be nice that Walker has a moped now because we won't ever pay for an Uber. We'll just all three of us hop on a moped.
Yeah, I don't think it'll work. I talked to Maya about that, and she said three. It'll be hard to move that thing. We got combined almost like 600 pounds.
Yeah, we'll still do it.
Yeah, it'll be fine.
Yeah, we'll try it.
Also, yeah.
Cool.
It's your deposit, man.
Yeah, whoever's in the middle doesn't need a helmet also because the two helmets in the front and the back surrounding.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, you'll be fine.
Yeah, sweet.
Sweet.
Anyways, Evan got ripped off by Uber the other day.
I was on our way back from the rock climbing thing, and you know, you checked, like, hey, like, are the tree we live off is, like, Hong Hao Tam. And so I see that, and he's like, yeah, thumbs up. And so then we're on this bike for 20 minutes or whatever, and then he, like, motions me to get off, and I'm like, what? Like, I don't know, I have no idea where I'm at. Look at the map, and he took me, like, to a different district, and I just haven't been paying attention. So he had to, like, take me all the way back over to my district, so it ended up being, like, triple the cost normal, which still was only $4, but it hurts, you know? Relative cost is big here. Like,
yeah,
we're learning
Yeah, you gotta think in dong, not in dollars.
Yeah.
That's one thing, like, I was thinking, I checked my bank account, I got, like, logged out, and I had to get a secure access code, so it'd been, like, 2 weeks since I checked my bank, and I was like, man, these Ubers are probably gonna be adding up.
They do.
And I logged in, and it was, like, $2, $2, $2.
And then you divide the $2 by three of us paying you for our part.
Yeah, so it's really like, oh, okay, that's right. But you think in dong, like, an Uber ride is, like, two meals a meal.
Yeah, yeah.
It's a good meal.
Yeah, maybe.
Like, if you pay $68K for an Uber.
Yeah.
A next meal or two. Thing, do you wanna talk about the construction?
Sure. There's our Airbnb. We decided to, like, stay here longer for another couple weeks. Just we got other stuff going on, and getting a new place would just be bad timing right now. So we're staying longer. But these people were expecting us to be out, so they're like, you know, we're gonna have some construction going on for these, like, next couple days. No big deal, we'll, like, cut you a deal for those days. We're like, yeah, no problem. And, like, I don't know what these are. There's all sorts of construction going on.
We'll show you at the end. The classic tour at the end. We'll do a quick tour.
Yeah, we'll show you. They're like, making it so it can be, like, multiple families living here at once or something.
They're making it
but
really
it is
loud.
Loud here. It is so loud.
They're making it really loud.
Yeah. But it's fine. I mean, it is what it is.
Yeah. It's funny, though. What we're gonna post a funny video about it eventually, and you will laugh maybe,
yeah.
Or you won't. And if you don't, you won't laugh.
We might laugh if you don't laugh, because we were, like, expecting you to laugh.
But despite the noise, Evan has gotten his narcolepsy back.
Yeah.
Really happy for you, man.
Thanks,
really,
man. Yeah, it's big. So I mean, I am famous for sleeping all the time, or being able to sleep very easily, and. As you know, for the risk of burglary and the heat, I have been not getting much sleep. But I'm back to it where I can sleep a full night, get a full night's rest. I've been climatized and desensitized to the fact that someone could steal all of our shit. So
it's good. Probably.
I can sleep again. It's good.
Yeah. And he's got this mustache coming in. You might not be able to see it because his beard is starting to catch up to it as well. But he's rocking the stash. And
well,
carrying the torch till mine comes.
Yeah,
back.
To like a week. Yeah, this is 2.5 weeks right here. And Walker's probably going to catch up to me in like 3 days. He shaved like. Anyway.
Yeah, what was it? I think it was like 5 days ago, maybe.
Give me another 2 weeks,
five?
Though, and I'm going to look heckin' good.
You will. So that's something that happened is. I lost a high stakes poker game to this girl from Hanoi, and yeah, basically she was like, "If let's play poker, and if you lose, I'm gonna shave your face." And she.
What if she lost?
Yeah, she just had to stop asking to shave my face. So it was really like it was a high stakes game, and I was pretty confident because I remember her telling me that she'd never played poker before.
That was a lie.
And
then
I saw her just
shuffle
she's
those
shuffling.
Cards.
She's like, six, 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 six. I was like, oh, this is going to be bad. Evan took me down pretty low in, like, one of the first hands.
Yeah, pretty good. Poker.
And basically, it's gone. There's a video up on our channel where I get shaved. You can watch it and relive it. It's only been about 6 months since I've been like this, but it's been probably like a year or more since I've taken a razor and gone completely down, which I think looks terrible, awful.
You look fine.
I look fine now, yeah, but
you look gross. Yeah. It's not beer on the bush. Here,
look,
guys.
Just watch our welcome video and you'll see.
You look gross. We are so self-conscious right now.
Yeah, it was weird. I felt very self-conscious, very vulnerable.
I could tell, man.
Yeah, it was palpable.
Yeah, it was.
Yeah.
Anyways. Oh, it's worth saying, I forgot to bring it up, but our mic stand, as you know, we do like to feature new mics every time, just a random piece of wire from the construction that is now our mic stand. So
yeah, it's a good one.
It is. One thing we also wanted to say was, you know, our last video, I think we talked about how this is loud to be talking here at night, and it's just so weird. We're in the middle of the city, and it's just dead silent at night.
Yeah.
Which is kind of a cool thing. Something I never expected because I never lived in a big city. But what's funny is every now and then you'll hear a cat fight, and those things are loud, man.
Yeah. Cutting through the silence.
There's a cat fight the other day off the back porch. I woke up to it for sure. It was just meow.
It gets loud.
Like two of them
so
doing
loud.
That, and then I heard them, and I think it was the cat that was that you and me that looked down and saw that cat look up at us.
Yeah.
I think it was that cat. Because
why?
It was right there,
yeah.
And I like shined the light on them, and I could see the cat.
Oh,
but they collided, and I heard like the collision, and then I heard like slipping and sliding down the tin roof, and then it was like an injured sounding meow. So,
well, they both landed on their feet.
That's true. That's one thing we do know.
Yeah,
can confirm.
Correct.
It
was heckin' loud.
I guess one thing we could talk about is a thought. So we mentioned being in spectacles earlier. One thought, on Friday night, it was midnight. Andy and I are walking to a 24-hour like little grocery store place. And I brought up to Andy, I was like, you know, what's pretty cool about right now is we're a spectacle for what I was thinking was like a cool reason, right? It's like
a different reason.
A different reason is that we're two white guys on a Friday night at midnight, like just in the neighborhood, while we walk into the 24-hour mini stop, and we're just like there, just like living, and people.
Grab a couple things.
Yeah, and I just think it's so cool to be a spectacle where it's like, hey, that guy, those guys just live there, live here, like they're not.
They're not like getting wasted and like on Bouillon Street.
Yeah, it's a cool feeling.
Not that there's anything wrong with that.
No.
I think there's something wrong with it. You're sinning.
Here, you sober boy.
Sober.
How much longer you got, bud?
It's the 17th. I have till the 4th. So, like, 13, 17 days?
You getting the shakes?
About halfway there.
You getting the shakes?
No, but I haven't slept in days. I need that nighttime beer. It's been fine.
Right here for you,
it
buddy.
Does feel like it's been a long time, though.
Yeah.
I was thinking the other day, it feels like it's been a long time. But I feel good. I look fantastic, if you can't tell.
You're glowing, man.
Yeah.
Really.
I'm glowing a new beard. That was rough.
Subscribe.
Whoa.
Give a thumbs up for that.
Dude.
Give a thumbs down for that.
Anyways, I am glowing a new beard soon, so.
Right.
It'll be back.
But in the meantime, you've been drinking a lot of jasmine tea.
Oh, the jasmine tea. That's, I made an Instagram post the other, like a week ago, about just like the small things about a place that I really enjoy. And a lot of it has to do with the food culture. Like in China, it was the washing of the dishes at the table before you eat, at least in southern China. Here, it's this little glass of jasmine tea that they bring out at coffee shops
and restaurants.
And
too.
Restaurants.
Yeah.
Everywhere.
Yeah.
And it's just the most refreshing thing for some
it's
reason.
It's like barely even good, but I love like it's you barely
so
taste anything.
Yeah.
It's almost like you gotta try to taste it, but it's so good.
It's so
in
refreshing.
Such an odd way. I'm
gonna
miss it a lot. I know that.
Yeah, it's amazing. And that's the stuff that like if going back to southern China, when I hear the clink 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 clink, it'll bring back all
of
those
the cleaning
positive
of the
emotions. Yeah. And I think I made a pretty bad hand gesture. I was just kind of, but
keep going,
but it'll just bring back those feelings, and like Saigon and the jasmine tea will always have a positive memory or association to
what I'm gonna miss more than anything is this little restaurant in our alley. And they have one meal that is this little piece of little flap of beef and a fried egg and French fries, surprisingly.
And a little salad.
And like two tomatoes and a flap of lettuce or something. And I go there every day, and I probably order like five meals, five of those per day, because, you know, the portion sizes are a tad small here.
Also, if you don't know Andy, he's a very routine eater. He will go and get really into one thing and just eat that same thing for longer than anybody really else can.
Right. That's been my thing. I'll go there, I'll show up and be like, I'll have three of these plates. And he'll laugh at me and he'll come bring me some jasmine tea, slap down some plates, I'll sit there and eat three meals of food.
He's a good guy too.
It's also funny though, is because this has happened at several restaurants now, where they recognize Andy and that he eats more. So it's like at first they laugh, and you know the whole staff usually is sort of giggling about the fact that this guy's ordering two or three meals. But you know, as time goes on, they're like, oh, here he is, three more meals. Like, start cooking them, you know.
Yeah. And cleans his plates.
Yeah.
Like a good Iowa boy.
Mom and dad.
Another thing. This is kind of back to the jasmine tea. But it's like cultural differences here, as far as things we have to adjust to. What I'm trying to get to is that Evan the other
day...
We'll
edit that part out.
Yeah. We were about to leave a place, like get our Uber, and our glasses of jasmine tea were empty. And so they're pouring us more, and Evan's like, no, don't, we're about to leave, trying to communicate. Really, it's okay, we're about to leave.
You didn't want him to waste tea on us.
Yeah, but the thing is, when we're thinking about it being like wasting tea, it would be, and like that being wrong for us, for them it's like they're showing hospitality. It's a very like Asian thing to fill you up, and if you like in China, if you're drinking, they'll fill you up every time. And so if you don't want to drink, you leave your glass with
full
booze in it. Yeah. And it's like their job is to give you hospitality and fill that glass. And if, you know, that's the thing. It's not wasting. It would be bad for them, and they would feel like they weren't doing their job correctly if they didn't fill you up. Even if you're about to leave, they make it in bulk. So also the margins are so low on that baby. So high. So it's free.
Yeah, so they're pretty low.
Yeah.
Well, we don't have that much more to talk about, really. I guess I do drink more coffee now. My whole life I've abstained from the coffee game because I was like, it's just I don't want to get in that route where it's like you gotta have a coffee every day. But since I'm here, it's like it's a huge part of the culture. There's cafes everywhere. We've talked about how our street's lined with them. But yeah, today I had like three coffees just because it's so cheap, and you go to a cafe and like
your pupils are a bit dilated.
Yeah. We might have to edit and put him on 0.75 speed.
No, I had three coffees, cafe soda, which is coffee with milk, and I had one matcha, and matcha also has caffeine in it.
Yeah, yeah.
So that is way more caffeine than I ever consumed before. So
how are you feeling, man?
It's funny.
Everything's slow motion.
Yeah, there are some times when, like the one day when I had two coffees at the coffee shop, where it was like, I felt drunk, sort of. Like, there was just this energy in my body. And, I mean, I've never, Vietnamese coffee is stronger, right?
Yeah, it's something.
But I'm just like, I'll have like 5 minutes of just this weird, like I've had four beers and you're just starting to buzz, you know? It's so weird. Yeah.
That's legit, man.
Anyway.
After this sober month, I'm going to have four beers and be out.
Yeah, dude.
I'm excited for that.
Well, I guess one thing we're... with our YouTube channel, we're going to start uploading just quick little clips of the week and do just, hey, this kind of our week in videos, which will be a short two-minute video or so.
It'll be more digestible than just like very long-form video like this.
Because if you're watching this right now, you're one of...
Our parents.
Oh gosh, yeah. Subscribe. So subscribe, please.
Subscribe, Mom.
Hey guys. Mike, Noel, thanks for watching still. But anyway, so we'll make some shorter videos. We also, if you might have seen, I posted what we called an armchair video. And really it's just like sharing some of our thoughts. My last one was about memory recollection, and periodically we'll post a video about us, like, kind of expressing what are the thoughts we've been having recently. But other than that, no, I think we're pretty, that's the doorbell right there. I think we're pretty good.
Cool.
Hey, thanks for joining us.